I don't think it's a problem that's going to disappear. If anything, it's a problem that's going to increase as more scooters become available.
They're calling it an emergency room epidemic. A new study out of the States showing that e-scooting is not as carefree as you might think. In fact, nearly half of serious injuries on e-scooters are fueled by substances like alcohol and drugs.
People aren't really giving these devices the respect that they deserve. Just like you wouldn't, you know, try and operate a motor vehicle or a motorcycle while you're impaired, the same should be done for these electronic scooters.
The study, spearheaded by ER doctors in the U.S., looked at 103 patients treated at three separate trauma centers for e-scooter-related injuries. It found that 79% of patients had alcohol in their system. Of the 79%, nearly half had a blood alcohol level more than 0.08, higher than the legal limit for drivers in Alberta. Most of those injured, males between the age of 20 and 40 years old.
This is just one other tool that we're, you know, making available to males that are going to hurt themselves.
Over half of the patients injured were severe enough that they required surgery. Others were not as fortunate.
All three of our centers have had deaths. And some of us have had multiple.
In Calgary, e-scooters fall under the traffic bylaw, meaning if you are found to be operating an e-scooter under the influence, you could face the same penalties as you would if you were driving a vehicle. E-scooter companies like Lime and Bird say their priority is the safety of their riders. Lime goes on to point out a drunk riding deterrence on their app. After 10 p.m., the app alerts riders to the dangers of driving impaired and asks them to type in the word yes. And if you can't manage those three letters, you're locked out until the next morning. However, this feature isn't available in their app in Calgary and is only available in select cities where it's been rolled out. Doctors say there needs to be more public education and enforcement. But just like you would with a vehicle, you should think before you ride. In Calgary, Allie Miller, City News.